I'm actually having more fun now than I ever have. You know, I've just, I'm surrounded by really good people, and that makes me happy. And Stu has, he's just such a great guy, and he's such a, he's a great spirit, and we just have so much fucking fun together. We get into trouble together, too, because we have too much fun. Sometimes that happens. But it's great, you know. I mean, the chemistry is really good. And then, you know, I have a great manager who we just, our chemistry is great. And I mean, there's a lot of really good stuff happening. So, I mean, I'm having more fun now than I ever have. And even with the immense amount of work that it is, I don't enjoy sitting in fucking airports and airplanes for hours or tour buses or whatever. But, you know, and even being on stage, as great as it is, that to me, the stress and the pressure of the songwriting part of making a record is a very, it takes it out of me, but it's always worth it. You know, all the stuff that you go through from the time the writing starts to the rehearsals, to the production itself. And I mean, it's a long process, but it's very rewarding. It's the most rewarding thing when what's in here actually happens. Writing process that Stu and I did down in Uruguay was pretty cool.
As soon as we get together, that chemistry again happens, and then we sort of have to sometimes, when things sort of explode in that manner, we have to sort of control ourselves again. So yeah, the first 3 days we didn't really get much done, but really get back to the bonding process again, and drink with each other and eat, and it was fun.
It had been a couple months since we had seen each other, I guess, and we just got hammered for like 2 days or 3 days in a row.
There was one night, there was just a raging storm happening on the beach, and we were really hammered, and we were yelling at the gods, I think we were really just getting prepared to embark upon this amazing journey that's going to be Plagues of Babylon.
The way we did it down there was, I've had, you know, whatever, 4 or 5 files prepared, so I would put him in a different room and he'd start working on vocal melodies and vocal cadences and lyrical ideas. We would discuss the vibe of the music and what direction it should go in. And then I was in the other room working on new arrangements and putting stuff together.
Sometimes he gives me a song and everything just falls into place for me. And I write all the lyrics and the melodies and everything, and it just happens. But I really like John's guidance on it because he's a great songwriter, and he knows how to write a really good melody, and he knows how to take a good idea and bounce it back and forth and make it even better.
But we're both very inspired, and so are the other guys, you know, and they contributed some cool ideas too.
He always tries to encourage trying new things and see what works. He's not afraid of walking into the dark and into the fire and trying something new. And sometimes you come out unscathed, sometimes you get burnt, but you learn from it. His mentality is anything goes as long as it's good, you know? So I think that's a great mentality. And that's what makes each Iced Earth record its own gem.
On Dystopia, I had to fly back and forth from Europe back to the States to Tampa to work at the studio.
basic tracking, overdub, and mixing happened in between the festivals. So John would literally leave Florida on a Thursday, land here on a Friday morning, play Friday, Saturday, sometimes Sunday, jump on a plane Monday, be in the studio from Monday through Thursday. John had the burden of like flying back and forth like crazy.
I was jet lagged the entire summer, and or at least for those 8 or 10 weeks that it was happening. And so I told my manager Ulf, I said, man, I really don't want to do that again.
We had a bunch of festivals really spread out from June through August. So we just figured, okay, we're going to make the record in Europe.
We had kind of a small window.
Would fit in. He's got the same sort of humor as us.
This is our new drummer, Rafael Saini.
Yeah. Hi everyone.
We been having lots of fun, man. He's doing a good job. Working hard.
Yeah.
So now the whip gets cracked tomorrow.
That's right.
Well, Monday.
Tomorrow we get
tomorrow
ready.
We get started. And there we go.
Can't wait, man.
All right, now get out of here. You're squishing my leg.
Rafael, you know, got a ton of stuff thrown on him right at the beginning. He had to learn a touring set because we're doing festivals and all the new stuff.
We've been going back and forth. Festivals in Germany, in Belgium, we also went to India, you know. So we had to kind of split our brains in two.
It's still fun, but you have, for me especially, I have a pretty giant weight on my shoulders when it comes to this kind of stuff. And I just don't like the distractions. And it feels like a distraction right now. So the goal is to not, I don't want to be in this position again. I just want to focus on writing, do a new record next time, and then we go out and have fun on stage. What I wanted to do was take the zombie apocalypse and apply it into the Something Wicked universe. And so it's pretty cool. And that's where I came up with the title Plagues of Babylon, as the Anglo-American Empire is basically the new Babylon. And so we, you know, There's a lot of real world messaging in the lyrics, but it's also got a cool horror vibe to it and sci-fi, and it all fits in with all the other stuff from the Something Wicked universe.
We're pretty heavy guys, so we're deep thinkers, and we love to think. You know, we like to think deeply about things and dissect things and analyze them and base our own opinions.
The basic story is that the Sessions, who are controlling the government.